wiki.easyvid.com. Search EasyVid Wiki before you decide. EasyVid presents the 10 best Mexican history books. Let's get started with the list. Starting off our list at number 10, The Olmecs is an introductory book on the oldest civilization in the Americas, best known today for the heads they carved out of large boulders. If you want to go all the way back to the beginning, this is as good an overview as exists. Any speculation is clearly marked and it includes interesting archaeological facts. However, some of the information is dated. At number 9, if you're interested in major political personalities rather than economic or geopolitical forces, Mexico, Biography of Power will be right up your alley. It offers a swath of biographical information about the players to help you understand the country's history. It's comprehensive at nearly 900 pages and written by a Mexican intellectual, but it can be hard to follow. Coming in at number 8 on our list, told through the eyes of Bernal Diaz del Castillo, a foot soldier under the ruthless Hernan Cortes, The Conquest of New Spain chronicles the Spanish landing on Mexican soil in 1520 and the subsequent exploitation and overthrow of Montezuma and the Aztec Empire. It's a highly detailed account with keen observations, though it can get tedious at times. Our newest choices can only be seen at wiki.easyvid.com. Go there now and search for Mexican history books, or simply click beneath this video. At number 7, those interested in teaching or who prefer textbooks to something with more of a narrative focus might find the course of Mexican history to be their best bet. It works especially well as a reference book. It conveys information quickly and is revised regularly with new research, but its depth is wanting. Moving up our list to number 6, Mexico in World History probably shouldn't be your introduction to the country, but for those who have a good idea of how the nation has progressed, it can provide important context to the various developments it's undergone. It's full of compelling anecdotes and is a solid resource on foreign invasions, though the writing can be dry. Halfway up our list at number 5, covering one of the most widely studied eras of Mexican history, the Women's Revolution in Mexico is a good supplement for dedicated scholars. Spanning a 40-year period during the war and after, it takes a fresh look at a heavily researched time. It includes personal stories and is an impressively coherent collection, with insight into small communities. At number 4, The Irish Soldiers of Mexico tells the story of John Riley and the St. Patrick's Battalion, a group of deserters from the U.S. Army who switched sides during the Mexican-American War. It deftly explores the motivations of men who made a seemingly baffling decision. It sheds light on little-known history and doesn't gloss over American misdeeds. It takes a hard look at manifest destiny. Nearing the top of our list at number 3, Villa and Zapata looks at two of the leading figures of the Mexican Revolution at the turn of the 20th century, though neither of them became the head of the resulting government. It's a great way to start understanding an important historical moment. It reads almost like a Western novel and takes a politically balanced approach. It includes an impressive list of sources. Our newest choices can only be seen at wiki.easyvid.com. Go there now and search for Mexican history books, or simply click beneath this video. At number 2, A New Compact History of Mexico comes from El Colegio de Mexico, one of the country's most prestigious academic publishers. The name refers to the length of the text rather than its purview, which begins in 40,000 BCE and continues to the present day. This is a multi-authored effort that's more into processes than people. It suggests good further reading. And taking the top spot on our list, The Mexico Reader is ideal for students or amateur historians who are as interested in the culture and politics of the country as they are in a strict series of events. It puts poetry and communiques next to historical sources, providing a sense of context. It includes many primary sources and features lots of different viewpoints. It addresses the role of the church too. Our newest choices can only be seen at wiki.easyvid.com. Go there now and search for Mexican history books, or simply click beneath this video.